I said, if you're so smart, why don't you donate your brain to science?
Oh, Margie, I'm sorry I'm late. See, I was on the phone with my friend Carlos, my roommate. See, he's a crossing guard, right? And every night, day about this time, he get these anxiety attacks, and I have to call and calm him down. And it's just, he's just hopeless, simply hopeless.
Oh, well, hopeless, I'll give you hopeless. Try waking up alone on your 40th birthday to the reality that your only raison d'etre is finding a kennel where your Yorkie won't get ringworm.
Girl, did you turn 40 years old today?
Bad news travels fast.
Well, happy birthday to you. And as the poem once says, you're not getting older, you're getting better. And let me tell you something. Truthfully, age ain't nothing but a state of mind. And girl, I don't live in that state.
Dion, your work keeps you young. Envy, envy. You know, I've never worked a day in my life, unless you count that stint at the fat farm.
I'm gonna tell you something, girl. This job ain't no bed of roses, is it? Am I lying? I ain't lying. I'm gonna tell you, sometimes I go home and I have what they call professional nightmares, because it's a stress-filled job. And oftentimes I go to bed, and in the middle of the night, I start dreaming these terrible dreams, and I wake up screaming.
You poor dear.
Mm-hmm. Well, last night was the worst. I tell you, I was dreaming that I was butt naked, right? And I was getting ready to dive in this pool, and my skin was all glistening, just like that man in the Chanel commercial. And I was getting ready to dive inside the pool, and I dived in, and I was swimming. It was all tranquil. Then all of a sudden, I'm like, all these West Indians start teeming around me inside the pool, right? And I at first, I was going to make friends with them, because I thought it was like an exile to reunite Africans or something like that. And then all of a sudden, they start getting rough with me and start holding me under the water. And I'm a big fan of juju music, right? But I was kind of confused in the beginning. So I start screaming and hollering, and I start reaching out, and I scratch up Carlos. He said, wake up and smack me. And I woke up, I was screaming.
Oh, how awful for you.
Really, I think I was subconsciously coming to grips with myself. I think deep down inside, subconsciously, I don't like naked Rastafarians.
Wow, well, that is one of the wildest dreams I've ever heard. Almost as wild as the one I had last night. Now, what do you think of this? Mm-hmm. In the dream, I go to a dinner party at Joe and Estee Lauder's. Mm-hmm. When I get there, there's no place card for me.
What?
Isn't that awful?
I can't believe that.
Neither could I. So I go to the cloakroom to get my sable, you know?
The brown sable?
Yeah.
Girl, I love that coat.
Well, I'll leave it to
you. I love that coat.
I know you do.
That is a sweet coat.
Well, you're going to get it when I go, I'll tell you that.
Promise?
I promise. So
I'm a mess.
You are not a mess. I adore you. Anyway, this girl, instead of the sable, she gives me a corduroy coat.
What?
Is that disgusting
instead
or what?
Instead of the brown sable?
That's right.
Well, I know you slept in this dream.
Well, anyway, my ex-husband, he suddenly appears in the dream. He flies up into the air and he skywrites, Marjorie can't cook. I was devastated. Then I'm on a horse and I'm saying, hi ho, Silver.
Now that's fascinating. You know what that dream means, don't you?
Well, I guess it means I'm 40 years old and I like to straddle horses.
Oh, no, girl, you're reading it all wrong. See, the silver in your dream signifies a silver lining. Your life is looking ready to be on the upswing. You are on the brink of spiritual rebirth.
Well, bless you for your optimism, Dion. I guess the glass is always half full for you.
Mr. Dion, call on line 3.
Oh, that's probably Carlos. I got to go talk to him because he's just a mess. He's Puerto Rican. You know how they be acting when they upset. I'll talk to you a few minutes.
All right, sweetheart. He's done wonders for me, hasn't he? My God, I look like a squirrel. Oh, dear.